Hello, I'm Eric Singer. This is Argonne's Public Affairs Science and Technology Past Fusion Cell Flash Briefing. Are you and your community ready for an emergency? A new year means new challenges to be ready. A perfect person to talk about that is Be Ready Utah Program Manager Wade Matthews with the Utah Division of Emergency Management. Thanks for joining us, Wade.
My pleasure.
Be ready is more than just a buzz phrase for you and your job. Let's talk about what you do.
It's our mantra really here in Utah. Be Ready Utah is our public outreach campaign for the Division of Emergency Management. And our goal basically is to try to reach the public, all the audiences that we can within the public, because everyone needs to hear the preparedness message, but to encourage them to take some action towards preparedness. And we use a lot of different methods, the traditional things of public presentations and booths at fairs, printed materials in our website and so on. But we are trying to think outside of the box a little bit now.
You've been pushing the envelope to get free emergency preparedness in front of the folks you serve. Now, that's not easy to fight through all of the online and traditional distractions. How are you doing it, and how effective have you been?
Well, yeah, free definitely is important in our limited budget, and we're trying to do a lot more on social media now. The booths at fairs, I don't find those to be as effective. So we're trying to do more with video. You know, everybody is all about video now. We're trying to do more with video and doing those on our social media accounts. We know that fear doesn't motivate people, so we've kind of got this new campaign going on. Anytime is a good time to talk about emergency preparedness. And we're just doing short little videos that show that people can talk about preparedness anytime, whether they're at work or at the store or someplace else. And we even got the governor and lieutenant governor to do one for us.
You've been getting thousands of views on these videos. In one in particular that was 45 seconds long, you had more than 13,000 views. Let's talk about it.
That one is a fun video. It's just a grab-and-go kit, a disaster supply kit that essentially builds itself. And it was the idea of our public information officer, Joe Doherty, here, who was just at home one evening playing around with his camera, and he got the idea to do stop-action, stop-motion video. You know, it's an old idea, but we used that old idea to do something new with it, where we've got all these different preparedness items that kind of do a little dance to some classical music. It's just catchy little music, and it builds itself inside a disaster a backpack. And yeah, it has had a lot of views. It's I think one of the very first ones that we did.
You've got to build a foundation. So what strategy would you give someone to do what you do in your state?
Something that's helped me a lot is to have a good team, actually. And I know a lot of public information officers out there are one-man band, but if they can identify some other people, you know, in a neighboring department or something like that, that they can pull resources together or start bouncing ideas off of each other and have a team, then identify what your specialties and outreach tools are that you can use to their most benefit, but then to, again, as I said earlier, think outside the box. We've started doing these little public service announcements. As I said, any time is a good time to talk about emergency preparedness. They cost nothing to produce. We're using a cell phone camera and a couple lavalier microphones, and we just kind of write a little script and recruit from within for our own actors, so everybody kind of enjoys doing it. And then we post those videos on social media. We do a premiere on Facebook so that they're viewed as live at a certain time. Then our Twitter links to the YouTube premiere as well. And so we're getting a lot of good feedback on those. People enjoy watching them. They enjoy sharing them. And hopefully that helps reach our goal for helping people take action towards preparedness.
Anything you'd like to add?
Another thing that we're doing new this year, I guess, is our social media engagement. I know that's a common thing, but something that we haven't really done very well here, I feel like. So we're trying to do more about that one-on-one engagement with our social media viewers, our friends and the likes and so on, and doing more to increase that social media engagement. I think that would go a long way to increase our overall effectiveness of all the things that we're doing, our Be Ready Utah PrepCast and the public service announcements and our videos and all those things, by increasing that social media engagement.
Thanks, Wade, for joining us. That was Wade Matthews, Be Ready Utah Program Manager with the Utah Division of Emergency Management. If you'd like to hear previous Alexa Flash briefings that include best practices and tools to help your organization, like the Argonne Past Fusion Cell Facebook page, or connect on Twitter and Instagram at Past Fusion Cell. You can also check out the Past Fusion Cell's online toolkit and go to Insights for useful templates, information, and register for classes. Go to pastfusion.gss.anl.gov.